Hey guys, I am Ravenshield from ROBLOX Helpers. Today I am going to talk a little bit about the features of the new plugin Studio Build Suite. This plugin is developed by Fractality and is considered to be the official building plugin of the lead builders of Robloxia. It is currently in active development, which means new features are added on a regular basis. Alright, let's take a look at the plugin. If you're familiar with other Studio plugins for building, you will notice that this plugin shares the same setup as the command utility. I'll go through the tool from the top to the bottom, and I'll show a small demonstration of the different features. First off, we'll start with the movement section on the top. Move axis lets you move your selection on the world axis. The hotkey for this feature is Z. The world axis is constant and will not change when your selection is rotated. Move object lets you move your selection on its own axis. The hotkey for this feature is X. Do note that this will move all the objects of your selection on their own axis. That makes this tool great to implode or explode a circle, but if you use it on the wrong objects, like this car, you'll see that you only create a mess. Move first lets you move your entire selection based on the first selected object. The hotkey for this feature is C. For this tool, we also have an additional feature. If you middle click with your mouse on an object, you will set the axis to that object. Basically, that means you can move an entire object on another object's axis, like this car. Let's head to the next set of tools, the rotate section. Rotate pivot lets you rotate your entire selection around the first object. The hotkey for this feature is G. For this tool, we also have an additional feature. If you middle click with your mouse on an object, you will set the pivot to that object. You can now rotate your selection around the defined pivot point. If we combine this tool with the plugin's copy feature, we can easily create a circle of models. The copy feature is Shift plus C, and it will duplicate your selection. Rotate group lets you rotate your entire selection around the center of the group. The hotkey for this feature is H. It is worth noting that the axis it rotates around will always start aligned to the world axis. Use this to your benefit. Rotate object lets you rotate every part in your selection around their own axis. Hotkey for this feature is J. As you can see, it works exactly like move first, but with rotation. While we're in the rotate section, I'll jump down to the tool called Rotate Edge. Rotate Edge allows you to rotate the selection around an edge. It acts much like the pivot point, but requires an edge instead of a surface or center. To select the edge, simply hold Alt and click or drag on the edge. You'll see the yellow selection box appear. Alright, let's go back to the next section, Resize. Resize object lets you resize your selection in the direction you pull. The hotkey for this feature is R. Note that this feature works similar to Move object and Rotate object, but we're resizing. Resize center lets you resize your selection from the center and outwards, in the direction and counter direction of your pole. The hotkey for this feature is T. This tool is handy for filling in the gaps in an exploded circle. In addition to the frequently used build tools, the plugin also comes with two handy features, scale and type conversion. Scale lets you scale your entire selection proportionally based on your input. This works for all objects, including unions and meshes. It is worth noting that this tool creates a duplicate of your selection and scales that model up. Your first selection remains untouched. The conversion tool lets you convert your selection into another object. It will do nothing if the object cannot be converted to the target class, for example, a part to a model or similar. An example of a good conversion would be part to wedge part or cylinder mesh to special mesh. The last thing I'm going to go over in this rundown is how the general features of the plugin works. The creator of the plugin has added functionality which lets us set the scope we want to work in. Setting a scope means we limit what parts we can access through regular selection. This is very helpful if you only want to work in a particular model. To scope down to a lower level, we can double-click on the model we wish to scope into. To scope back out a level, we can just double-click anywhere that is not the current model we're scoped into. To directly set the scope to any part, we can shift plus double-click on any part and our scope will automatically be set to that part's parent. If we wish to select several objects at once, we can hold Ctrl while clicking. This plugin also allows us to drag our mouse over the objects to select them, as long as we still hold Ctrl. If you wish to select several objects independently from their scope, you can hold Ctrl plus Shift and click or drag your mouse. Do note that this will also select locked parts. And just to make sure you remember, this plugin also offers a feature to copy your model. To duplicate your selection, you can simply hit Shift plus C. This will duplicate your selection without moving it. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and make sure to subscribe to our channel and join us on Discord.